بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Honorable ulama, distinguished guests, respected brothers, elders, mothers and sisters in Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All of you sitting here will agree with me that it is our aqeedah, the aqeedah of the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, that we only speak good regarding the Sahaba, the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And love for the Sahaba is a part of Islam, whilst hatred for the Sahaba is disbelief and hypocrisy. So our attitude towards the Sahaba has to be that of love, has to be that of respect, and has to be that of purity from our minds and from our hearts, respected brothers and elders. And many places in the Quran, there isn't much time to go in, to delve into the verses of the Quran, wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks and praises the Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. And many ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he mentions the virtues of the Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. There is some virtues regarding the Sahaba, which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned all the Sahaba collectively. But then there is some virtues of the Sahaba where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned individual virtues of the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you can refer to the books of ahadith where you will find these ahadith on the virtues of the Sahaba rizwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in. But my point today is, like I said earlier, it is our aqeedah that the Sahaba rizwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in, we love the Sahaba and we only speak good of the Sahaba. But unfortunately, we are living in a world, we are living at a time where there is certain sects, certain people who, na'udhu billah, abuse the Sahaba, who speak ill of the Sahaba, who criticize the Sahaba. And from amongst those people, there are the Qadianis and Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani himself. Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani, he writes in one of his books, he says that the person who believes in the Quran, the person who believes in the Quran should throw away the statement of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu like you throw away rubbish. This was said about Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the one who narrated the most ahadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who was therefore one of the first graduates from the madrasa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani says that throw away the statement of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala like you throw away rubbish. And then one of the leaders of the Qadianis, he went through so much exaggeration in the praise of Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani, that he said that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they were not even worthy of untying the laces of Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani. Who are Abu Bakr and who are Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, اِقْتَدَوْ بِالَّذَيْنِ مِنْ بَعْدِ أَبِي بَكْر وَأُمَر. He says to the people, he says to the Sahaba, that after me follow Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Who was Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, a hadith recorded by Imam Ibn Majah in his Sunan, he says that the day Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu accepted Islam, that day Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, he came down to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Muhammad, laqad istabshara ahlu samai bi Islami Umar. That O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, today even the angels in the heavens are celebrating because Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu has accepted Islam. Who was Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu? And who Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu? Imam Tirmizi relates on the authority of Sayyidina Abu Sayyid Khudri radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Ajib, he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ma min nabiyin illa walahu wazirani min ahli sama wa wazirani min ahli al-ard. Fa amma waziraya min ahli sama fa Jibreel wa Mikael, wa amma waziraya min ahli al-ard fa Abu Bakr wa Umar. He says that that every prophet has been appointed with two ministers in the heavens and two ministers on the earth. The two ministers appointed for me in the heavens are Jibreel and Mikael, and the two ministers appointed to me for me on this earth are Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is praising Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The final messenger Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioning their virtues to the Ummah, and Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani is saying that the leaders of the Qadianis are saying that Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu were not even worthy of untying the laces of Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani. Astaghfirullah. And then Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani, in one of his books, he writes, he says that I am pouring, how he is pouring, Allah knows best. But he writes, I am pouring Karbala every moment of my life. For every moment of my life, I am pouring Karbala. And then he writes, Astaghfirullah, such tawheen of Hazrat Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says that I have 100 Hussains are always in my pocket. These are the thoughts, and these are the aqaid, and these are the views of the Qadianis regarding the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. It is our aqidah, respected brothers and elders, and it is our belief, not just our belief, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, he says that the Sahaba were such people. The Sahaba are such people, Allah himself says to them, that وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْإِسْيَانِ. It is our aqidah that the Anbiya are sinless. Anbiya are sinless. But we do not hold this aqidah, which is not our belief, that the Sahaba are also sinless. The Sahaba did commit sin. But there was one quality within the Sahaba that we don't have today. What is that quality? This is what Allah refers to in the Quran, wherein He says, وَكَرَّهَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْكُفْرَ وَالْفُسُوقَ وَالْإِسْيَانِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had made sin, had made disbelief, and all these things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sin and disbelief and disobedience, Allah has made it detestable to the Sahaba. In other words, the Sahaba were allergic to sin. The Sahaba had an allergy to sin. This is why whenever the Sahaba, whenever they would commit sin, straight away they would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me give you one example and then I'll finish inshallah. Ibn Kathir rahimahullahu ta'ala, in his commentary of the Quran, regarded as one of the most authentic commentaries of the Quran, and also one of the most beautiful commentaries of the Quran. In there, he mentions the narration. He says, and it's also been narrated by Abu Yala rahimahullah ta'ala in his Musnad. He says that one day a companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by the name of Ma'iz bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he says, O Messenger of Allah, I have committed adultery. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hears this, he turns away from it. So Ma'iz bin Malik says it the second time, O Allah's Messenger, I have committed adultery. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again turns away from him. He says it the third time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turns away. Then the fourth time, and then when he said it the fifth time, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam turns towards him and he says, Zanita? Then, O Ma'iz, have you really committed adultery? Ma'iz says, yes, O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have committed adultery. But subhanallah, look at Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He was sent down as a mercy for the entire mankind. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of you brothers sitting here, and all of you listeners know that in Islam, under the Sharia law, the punishment for one that commits adultery is being stoned to death. But when Ma'iz bin Malik says to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I have committed adultery, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not satisfied. Why is he not satisfied with the answer? Why is he not satisfied with his comment? Because وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةٍ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. He was a mercy for the whole mankind. That what if I punish Ma'iz? What if he is told, what if he is stoned to death? And later on it was found out that he didn't actually commit the full action of adultery. Then what is going to happen? So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he questioned him further. He said, "Oh Maiz, do you know hal tadri mazzina? Oh Maiz, do you know what zina is? Do you know what adultery is?" So Maiz bin Malik says, "Oh Allah's Messenger, I have done with her illegally what a husband does legally with his wife." Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is still not satisfied. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, "Oh Maiz, tell me, have you actually committed adultery? Did you actually go into her like how the rope goes into the well, or like how the surma, the stick goes into the surma container? Is this how you have gone into her?" So Maiz bin Malik says, "Yes, O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is what happened." Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is satisfied that Maiz bin Malik has indeed committed adultery. So he orders that Maiz bin Malik be stoned to death. Now whilst he is being stoned to death, there's two people there who Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam hears talking. And they are talking to each other and saying to each other, "Look at Maiz bin Malik. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had concealed his secret, but he could not rest until he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and confessed to what he has done. Look at the state of him now. He is being stoned to death like a dog is stoned." Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam hears this and lets it go. After the stoning has taken place, Maiz bin Malik is stoned to death. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the group of people, he is going back home. And on the way, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sees the corpse of a donkey, a dead donkey. So he says to those two people who he had heard talking and backbiting about Maiz bin Malik, he says to them, "Come here." So they come to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam says to them that, "I want you to eat from the corpse of this donkey." In shock, they say, "Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who would want to eat a meal like this? What a bad meal! How can we eat from the corpse of a donkey?" Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the backbiting and the bad speech that you did back there regarding your brother Maiz bin Malik, that is worse of a meal than the corpse of this donkey. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ إِنَّهُ الْآنَ لَفِي أَنْهَارِ الْجَنَّةِ يَنْغَمِسُ فِيهَا." He says, "I swear by that being in whose hands lies my life, at this very moment in time, Maiz bin Malik is swimming in the rivers of Jannah." And in another narration recorded by Imam Muslim rahmatullah alayhi in Sahih, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to the Sahaba, "Oh my Sahaba, istaghfiru li Maiz ibn Malik laqad taba tawbatan law qusimat bayna ummatin lawasiyatuhum." He says that, "Oh my Sahaba, seek forgiveness for Maiz bin Malik." Allah, he says, "Indeed, verily Maiz bin Malik, he has made such repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the guna he had committed, that had his tawbah, had his repentance been distributed amongst the whole ummah, it would be enough for every person." So respected brothers and elders, the point I'm trying to make is, in a nutshell, is that it is our aqeedah and our firm aqeedah regarding the Sahaba that all the Sahaba were trustworthy, and all the Sahaba, they were forgiven by Allah. All the Sahaba were granted the certificate of the happiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّ كُلَّمْ وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى. Time and time again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that all the Sahaba are forgiven. The Sahaba are the truthful ones. The Sahaba are the true mu'mins, the true believers. The Sahaba are the ones who have been promised husna by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And ask the ulama sitting here, what do the mufassirin, the experts in the field of the Quran, what do they say regarding the interpretation of the word husna? They all say that it means the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which results in direct entry into the Jannah. So this is our aqeedah, my respected brothers and elders. But the Qadianis aqeedah, like I mentioned earlier, you heard how they have aqaid regarding the Sahaba, na'uzu billah. That na'uzu billah, when I read this comment about Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala and Umar radiallahu ta'ala, that na'uzu billah, according to the Qadianis, they are not even worthy of untying the laces of Mirza Ghulam Ahmed Qadiani. How much shock I got, only Allah knows. And it is the non-believers, the staunchest enemies of Islam, even they had no choice but to praise Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Ajeeb. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, you all heard the name, better known as Mahatma Gandhi. What he would do is he would have a weekly newspaper. And in that weekly newspaper, in 1937, when the Congress Party came into power to govern India, Mahatma Gandhi advised his elected members and leaders to adopt simplicity in their lives. And these are his words. This is the exact translation of his words. He wrote to all of them, to the members. He said to them that I cannot give you the reference of Ramchandra or Krishna, which are the Hindu gods, because they were not historical figures. I cannot help it but to present to you the names of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala and Umar radiallahu ta'ala. They were leaders of a vast empire, yet they lived a life of austerity. And what does austerity mean? The trait of great self-denial, especially refraining from worldly pleasures. So this is a non-Muslim, regarded as an enemy of Islam, and he has no choice but to praise Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu ta'ala. And there is a saying in Arabic, Al-Fazlu ma shahidat bihil a'da, that excellence is that which has been testified to by an enemy. And just before I finish, Hakeemul Ummat, Hazrat Mawlana Ashraf Ali Thanvi rahmatullah alayhi, in his book, The Rights of Islam, Hukukul Islam, he writes that upon us, the Sahaba have four rights upon us. Four rights upon us, the Sahaba have. Number one, throughout our whole lives, we follow the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in. Number two, we love the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in. Number three, we have this firm aqeedah and this firm belief that all the Sahaba were trustworthy. And number four, he says that we love those people who love and admire the Sahaba, and we have hatred for those people who hate the Sahaba. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate the ranks of the Sahaba further. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.